Bada boom! Okay, okay, let me break this one down for you. Earlier this year, I was at faculty lunch when Kenta sat down next to me. Kenta studies aggression in flies, but generally knows a shit ton about them. So I asked him, "Hey man, what's new in the mushroom body today?" The mushroom body is part of the fly brain that we were studying in our previous science paper. It's a collection of neurons that processes information about odors. Kenta was like, "Oh, actually, my friend just published a paper recently on how fruit flies do novelty detection for odors. You know how I'm usually sitting all slouched?" Well, after he said that, I sat up and was like, "Wait, what? Novelty detection? How?" Because, I mean, think about it. What does it mean to be able to do novelty detection? It means that I've smelled a bunch of odors in the recent past, and then a new one comes in, and I need to quickly figure out, have I smelled this odor before? This is important because if something is novel, then it implies that there's something out there that may be important, that I should pay attention to, that I could maybe learn from. And you want to do this accurately because otherwise, you're just going to unnecessarily burden your attention on that doesn't matter. But how do you perform this comparison so efficiently? How do you quickly say, "Oh yeah, I've never smelled anything like this"? Novelty detection is also a fundamental problem in computer science. It's related to anomaly detection, outlier detection, and other such problems. But let me give you an example from Google. So Google has web crawlers that index the web. And when a web crawler reaches a website, it has to ask, "Have I already crawled this website before?" If so, then it could skip it and move on. But if not, in other words, if it's novel, then it goes in and does its thing. But how does Google solve novelty detection? So this takes us to MIT in the 1970s. Now stay with me here. This graduate student, Howard Bloom, invented a data structure called a Bloom filter to be able to quickly solve the novelty detection problem. Okay, so here's how it works. Instead of storing each item in the database in its entirety, a Bloom filter only stores a small fingerprint of each item using only a few bits of space for that item. Then, by checking whether the same fingerprint appears twice in the database, a system can quickly determine whether the item is a duplicate or something novel. Well, what we discovered after reading Kenta's boy's paper and thinking and thinking and thinking hard about it, was that fruit flies also evolved the Bloom filter to do novelty detection. But the fruit fly introduced a couple new twists that we elaborated and defined mathematically in this paper published in the journal PNAS. The fly's mushroom body novelty signal is generated using a fingerprint for odors akin to the Bloom filter's data fingerprint. When flies experience a new odor, mushroom body neurons broadcast a novelty alert signal, so the fly knows that this odor is new and worth investigating. If the odor doesn't have a strong impact, the next time it's experienced, the strength of the alert signal is reduced, and the fly doesn't waste time investigating that odor. Overall, this is one of the first data structures discovered in the brain, along with an algorithm for how the brain may perform novelty detection. The brain holds lots of secrets on how to solve data problems that come up in our everyday life. And our dream is to bring together computer science and neuroscience to unlock these secrets. So that's the story of how fruit flies, odors, and computer science came together.